My name is Tim Heidecker, and I'm at Amoeba Records.
Hello, I'm Jonathan Rado. I play keyboards in Tim's band.
And this is What's in My Bag.
Well, I'm gonna make it up to you, this I swear. Oh, yes, I do.
We got each other stuff.
Yeah.
I got you this.
Oh, I got you.
Oh my gosh.
Oh wow. Well, mine.
So you got me the one with some wear on it?
I got you somewhere, but I figured it was cheaper. It had a little bit of wear on this one.
Somewhere. That's a good name for an album, by the way. Somewhere.
Somewhere, yeah.
It's like a Bill Wyman 1983. It's a good pun because it's like somewhere. Or somewhere. I think this is my favorite Bruce Springsteen album.
Easily.
Would you say it's the same
Easily
for you?
My favorite Bruce Springsteen album.
A lot of songs about factories. Mm-hmm. And I like the cover a lot. It seems like not a lot of thought was put into it.
Yeah.
But then look what happens here. Let's try
off.
One with the jacket because.
Try taking off the jacket.
Today is like male singer-songwriters of the 70s,
right.
Which is sort of the inspiration
for your record.
For my record and music we connect on. So we couldn't forget Randy Newman.
Probably his most classic record, in my opinion.
You know, when you grow up, you have one perception of him because he's especially people your age.
Toy Story. Yeah.
And sort of the maker of kids' music. This is massive. It's really funny, beautifully performed.
We saw Randy Newman together.
Right, at the one of these Pemberton Music Festivals.
Right, in Canada.
It was a little strange, wasn't it?
It was a little uncomfortable. He was playing solo piano and
outdoors,
he was just drowned out by St. Vincent you know, on a different stage. And
poor Randy kept
he was
on
pretty
asking.
Upset.
He kept asking for them to turn the bass down.
Yeah, can you just turn the bass down on St. Vincent?
There was only like 150 people there, which is kind of sad. But then he played You Got a Friend in Me, and all these kids start coming
storming.
In, and it was like, for them, they're probably all an acid or something.
Yeah, and he really pushes it on this album.
Oh my God, you know? Well, he drops the N-word in the first track several times.
Yeah, it's the hook.
But it's the hook.
It's the hook of the song.
Yeah, and you end up singing it with the windows rolled down. A Wedding in Cherokee County, the standout track for me on this. Just
beautiful.
Sad and funny and beautiful.
Yeah,
Randy Newman.
Real good.
She knew how she'd be unfair.
One, two, three.
Different.
Different, but very similar.
Very similar.
The band.
Classic.
This has got great songs on it. Neither of these are my favorite band albums.
No.
Best album is The Band.
Self-titled The Band.
The second album.
I'm a fan of Stage Fright because it was recorded by Todd Rundgren. I'm a huge Rundgren fan, but also it just sounds terrible. It's a terrible sounding record.
They recorded it in some
old theater. They were all kind of
heroic. Just go in the studio and make music where it's professionally done, Robbie. This is a terrible painting by Bob Dylan, by the way. I wonder what pressure they were under to use this from him.
Probably a ton.
Yeah, you guys should use my painting, you guys, for the cover. Really?
Yeah,
for our first album in our
He's
studio.
He's like, no, look, I painted you, man. This is you,
Robbie, and then this is fucking Elephant Man. He's like, crazy. What is he doing there?
Look at you, Levon, over there by the tree. One of them's playing a sitar for some reason.
Yeah.
No
well, that's,
sitar
maybe
on
that's the
record.
Best Bob Dylan could do for a guitar. It's a child's painting done by an adult man. Bob Dylan. Terrible cover. Sorry. It's iconic, but terrible.
Take a load off, man.
This is the third man in the triumvirate of great 70s singer-songwriters.
Oh, huge.
Warren Zevon. He's great. The songs are, you know, they're in the same kind of Randy Newman way. They're funny and
funny,
pretty melody.
Sad.
Really good melodies. His piano playing is fantastic.
Yeah, and he's got a hot band on that record.
Great band.
Real hot.
But then he drops off because the records after this are kind of hard to get into.
Well, he starts drinking a lot.
He starts drinking a lot. One of the great rock and roll books is this
biography
about him.
He was a pretty bad guy.
He's a bad guy.
In a lot of ways.
Well,
and he kind of cleaned himself up.
He cleaned up, but he was still like this total disgusting pig when it came to like women. And
He loved Bruce Springsteen. There's a great story in the book where he's gonna go hang out with Bruce Springsteen and he gets mad at his wife and he I think he beats her and he's just yelling, you're gonna ruin my night with Springsteen? You're gonna ruin my night with Bruce? And it's a pretty brutal little section of the book.
Yeah. Waddy Wachtel is on this, one of the greats.
Yeah, Fleetwood Mac plays, their bass and drums, John McVay, and Mick Fleetwood play drums on Werewolves of London.
Werewolves of London.
Yeah, big hit.
Ring ding, ring ding. Werewolves of London.
I got this Elvis Costello, Burt Bacharach album called Painted from Memory in 1998. Great year for Costello and Bacharach.
I was really in
great collaboration.
In high school, I was really into Elvis Costello.
He was probably
my top five. This one I could not fall in love with.
You gotta revisit it.
But I'm excited to revisit it. Boy, Bacharach had the smile, didn't he?
Oh my God.
He knew how to turn it on. Always reminded me of Gary Marshall.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, he's the Gary Marshall of songwriting.
Yeah. God Give Me Strength, of course.
God Give Me Strength is the big song.
Incredible song.
Toledo is my favorite one. And does anybody in Ohio dream of that
Spanish citadel? Another core record for me is the Kinks' Arthur. What is it called? The full name is Arthur or The Decline and Fall of the British Empire. You could just call it Arthur. But geez, like one after another, like classic.
Beautiful. It's a concept record.
It's a concept record all about England and.
Yeah, it's sort of vague what the concept is, I can tell you. It's very war heavy, and then it becomes a little vague.
It falls apart a little bit. But you know,
The
songs are amazing. I think this group is so freaking influential, you know, like obviously you don't have things like Eleanor Rigby and Penny Lane. I think without the Kinks. So they're huge for me. Ray Davies is one of the greats.
Yeah. Kinks for me over the Beatles and the Stones.
Their records were always pretty sloppy too.
Yeah.
They were not like super polished.
It seems like it's like the third take, especially on this one. There's parts where it totally falls apart.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
I love it. So somebody, Amoeba, I suppose, is selling these mugs. It's not cool. They are not cool.
I like this one. I got this Bruce Springsteen mug.
There was three Pink Floyd mugs down there. There was The Wall, and there was Wish You Were Here. Mm-hmm. Then there was this, Division Bell. If you were in the market for a rock mug, and you were a Pink Floyd freak, and why would this ever be the choice? The reason is I would never want to have a rock mug. Because I would never serve a guest this, like...
I'm gonna drink this every morning.
But with this, there doesn't appear to be any signage or any kind of lettering on it that identifies it as Pink Floyd's The Division Bell. I think this album cover is not widely well known, and I bet I can get away with this as just a generic sculpture piece. It's a piece of art, it's a sculpture that I appreciate.
Yeah.
I don't know what it's associated with. The grass was greener. That's what we got.
Cool, thank you so much, guys.
No problem.
You're welcome. Stare at the ceiling, wait for the sickness to just go away. Oh.